So I just finished a session with a guy here in Hong Kong. He's got really, really super tight upper trapezius muscles. It's these ones up here. I also got a comment on the Muscles Are Not Like Taffy blog asking about tight upper trapezius muscles and about whether or not a ball is a good tool to roll out that tension and fix the problem. And it got me thinking about samurai. A katana is a two-handed sword, and when you use it, you hold the bottom of the handle with one hand, and on the top of the handle near the hilt with the other. And when you want to strike, you pull back with one hand, you push forward with the other, like this. And that bottom hand creates an input force, the top hand creates a fulcrum, and then the blade exhibits an output force. And because of leverage, the output force is very, very strong. And human shoulder blades work on exactly the same principle, only with less dismemberment. The shoulder blade is really very mobile, and it moves in all kinds of different directions. There's elevation and depression, which is shoulder blades sliding up the body and then sliding down the body. And then there's protraction and retraction, which is shoulder blades sliding around toward the anterior or back toward the spine. And if you combine those two directional forces, right, elevation, depression, protraction, retraction, you end up with a rotational vector, upward rotation or downward rotation. And as it turns out, because of the oblique nature of the serratus anterior muscle right here, that upward rotation, downward rotation is the way that force is carried through the shoulder and into the hand, or from the hand into the shoulder and down to the low body. And what I see a lot is that in a situation where the shoulder has become frozen or impinged or tight or immobile, it has something to do with the loss of rotation, right? One of the competing vectors of that rotation has gotten too strong. Usually, in my experience, elevation depression. So the guy I work with today, it was the same kind of thing. His shoulders were really super elevated. They were starting to climb up toward his ears. He was creating all kinds of tension, and it meant that shoulder movement was uncomfortable, painful, or even impossible. What I had to do with him was, first of all, manually manipulate his shoulder blades into upward rotation. And I would actually kind of get in there and dig around on the inferior angle. That's this point right here of the shoulder blade, right? So it slides in or it comes forward, slides in or comes forward. I would dig into that angle and assist in upwardly rotating while raising his arm for him. And as soon as he got a good kind of mental map of how to feel the shoulder blade through that rotation, we started gaining a lot of ground on range of motion. And I have a suspicion that the commenter that asked the question about tight traps is experiencing something similar. My suggestion would be to find a massage therapist or someone else who knows about kind of manual manipulation. Specifically ask them to mobilize your shoulder blade in upward and downward rotation. Get a good mental map of what that feels like and how you create that motion. And then in a really kind of light and unstressful way, experiment with it. Simple stuff like raising your arm overhead, right? Once you get above 60 degrees, you should begin to feel that motion, that upward rotation of the shoulder blade, not elevation, but upward rotation. Very different thing. So I hope that helps. Any other questions, of course, please feel free to ask. We'll have another one of these chats soon, I hope. All right, thanks, take care.